Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to XPS Tech. I am Vineet and it's the end of the year 2018 and just few days left before we get to 2019. And I think it's time to take a look back at how this year has been for Linux distro in general, the important news, releases, the good and not so good stuff that happened this year that gives you a perspective of everything important that shaped the world of Linux this year. Alright, so let's start today's video. Now this year started on a back foot with the entire tech industry tackling to fix the Meltdown and Spectre bugs which affected CPUs like Intel. It was a time when all major hardware companies and computer manufacturers were hastily releasing updates and patches for these vulnerabilities. Since the bug affected all Intel CPUs, it was something that was going to take a long time. And I hope by now you have patched your system for these vulnerabilities. Alright, now first let's talk about major acquisitions. There have been two major acquisitions this year. One was the biggest open source acquisition ever. IBM bought Red Hat Linux for $34 billion. Red Hat, if you don't know, is a popular Linux-based company that makes industry leader Linux distro, RHEL, and the free but bleeding edge distro, Fedora. Red Hat also celebrated its 25th anniversary this year. Red Hat was started in 1993, and back in the days, Red Hat was the first Linux-based company to enter into a successful business model with their paid Linux distro, Red Hat Linux. The second acquisition was of another industry giant, SUSE Linux, which was bought by a Swedish private equity firm from Micro Focus for $2.5 billion. SUSE business was acquired by Micro Focus in 2014. This is a great news for SUSE as Micro Focus was not doing very well. Also this year, SUSE Linux released OpenSUSE Leap version 15 with new features like transactional updates and seamless migration of the OS from free OpenSUSE to paid SUSE Linux Enterprise. I did a review of OpenSUSE 15 when it was released. You can check that video also. The link is in the description of this video. Alright, next, let's look at the major releases this year. As scheduled, in April, we had Ubuntu release its LTS version, Ubuntu 18.04. However, this year, the LTS release is special because unlike the previous LTS release, which were supported for 5 years, Mark Shuttleworth, owner of Canonical, announced that 18.04 will be supported for full 10 years, which is quite unprecedented and a great news for businesses and institutions that uses Ubuntu. 18.04 shipped with GNOME Desktop, and in October 18.10 was released, which was shipped with new and modern Yaru community theme on top of GNOME. Next is the major Linux distro from China, Dipin Linux, which in my opinion had the best year. They had 3 releases this year and made significant changes in their release strategy by adopting an aggressive 3-month update cycle with alternate focus on system optimization and desktop looks with every release. The other major release was of Elementary OS. The distro's much awaited version 5, Juno, was released with new features like pay what you want for apps, housekeeping app, etc. Manjaro, an Arch-based rolling release distro, also moved from 17 to version number 18, codenamed Illyria. The distro had been number 1 in the page head ranking on DistroWatch for this year. And recently they updated their website as well. Apart from that, after the release of Ubuntu 18.04, all other major Ubuntu based distro also updated their system. For example, Mint updated to Mint 19, which was released with Cinnamon 4 desktop. Pop OS 18.10 was also released, which is also based on Ubuntu. However, this year has also been the year we say goodbye to 32-bit systems. Almost all major Linux distro now have stopped supporting 32-bit system, and there are even ongoing talks to end Linux kernel support for 32-bit system, and the entire industry is sort of moving to the 64-bit system. Alright, next let's talk about the Microsoft and Linux relation, which got a little stronger this year. Remember, Microsoft introduced WSL or Windows Subsystem for Linux feature in 2017, which enabled Linux distro to run on Windows. Well, this year they added few more distros that can run on WSL like Debian and Kali Linux. Also, with the recent October update, they have made the integration between WSL and Windows a lot stronger by adding copy-paste feature and a new entry in their right-click menu for Linux. Microsoft also released their homemade Linux distro called WLinux, which is a Debian-based paid Linux distro. The cost of WLinux is $19.99, but as an introductory offer, you can get it for under $10 if you buy it before 31st December 2018. Right, next is Linux hardware. This year, we saw release of new hardware devices for Linux, like Mint updated their mini computer lineup called Mint Box. So Mint Box Mini 2 and Mint Box Mini 2 Pro was released this year. But the biggest news as far as Linux hardware is concerned is the launch of high-end desktop computer called Thelio by System76. It's the same company that makes Pop OS. The hardware configuration is pretty impressive and at par with the best PC or Mac configuration that you can get. The higher end models of Thelio have configuration that would give the computer giant like Microsoft and Apple run for their money. So it's great that you now have a high end option available for Linux distro as well. Alright, now let's get to not so good stuff. The founder of Linux Kernel and the current head of Linux Foundation, Linus Torvalds, was in a bit of controversy this year. He stepped down as head of Linux Foundation following a controversy related to his bad behavior and conduct. This also led to introduction of new code of conduct for Linux, which received a mixed bag of feelings, with some looking at this as a tool to go after developers and contributors who do not align with big corporation or men in power. The other kind of a sad news is regarding Solus OS, which I reviewed last year and believed had great potential. Well, its founder and lead developer Ikey Doherty has left the project without giving any hint. Months after he disappeared, he wrote this email to the community officially ending his further involvement with the project. Well, we have to see how it goes for Solus, and I really hope the community get over this and continue this project. We do not want to see such a great OS bite the dust. Alright, so that was some of the major events, news that shaped the Linux world this year. I thank you for watching this video. I hope you like this video. If you do, kindly press the like button. If you have any comment, suggestion or feedback related to this channel, type that in the comment box. And if you want to see more such Linux related videos, please subscribe to my channel XPS Tech. And I wish all the subscribers and viewers of this video Merry Christmas and a very happy new year. Alright, so thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.